Hello everyone, and hi again. So I think we can start. Okay, so we're gonna tell you the story of the Thales Digital Factory, and in this journey what we have done on the platform side. That's the goal of the talk today, and how Cloud Foundry help us on how Pivotal help us in this journey of Cloud Foundry also. So I am Nicolas Dumont. I'm the product owner of the CorePass services at Thales Digital Factory. We'll go back in a minute on what is Thales Digital Factory. And I am with Erwan.
So Erwan Bornier, so I'm platform architect working with Thales Digital Factory, but also Thales broadly. But I'm not the only one from Pivotal. There is also an account team, and there is people that have done the dojo that we will see later today. So thanks to them also. So I just take the time at the beginning of the session to say it.
Okay, so we're going to start with what is the Digital Factory, what is our mission in Thales. So Thales Digital Factory is a new entity of the Thales Group, which is a big group with 60,000 employees, a lot of engineers, and maybe 20,000 engineers. And in these 20,000 engineers, there are a lot of software developers. So, and in the Thales Group, we are facing, as everyone, the transformation of the world, and we, on Thales Group, decide to create a new entity, Thales Digital Factory, to tackle the challenges of this digital transformation. So I won't do a full explanation of the process. I will focus everything related to Cloud Foundry, the technology, and the way we use this technology, which is also innovative. So that would be the focus on the talk, so I won't go into all the details of the slide. So as part of this digital transformation, one important thing for Thales is to be able to adopt a product as a service approach. Let's say in the old time in Thales, when we had a project, it's usually a big project, and we develop software, we develop systems, and we develop a platform. And what we deliver to the clients, it's a platform plus operator plus software on it plus system. And it's, in fact, we deliver something which is really heavy and which is not really agile. So one of the goals of the Thales Digital Factory is to transform this and to have a product as a service mindset and to deliver something as a service. So that's one of the key points here. Also, a thing that is difficult for us in Thales is to be user-centric. The customer of Thales and the end user are quite far from the dev teams, so it's really difficult to get in touch with them, to get their feedback. So that's one aspect. Another aspect is we add a traditional way to address project with a V-cycle, which is a long process to select the solution and to build it without talking basically to the user. So one important aspect of our digital transformation is to put the end user and the users in the center of our development experience. And all of this, we want to change the way we work together as team and adopt the agile paradigm. So that's, I won't insist on the other topic, but that's what is at stake here. So the Digital Factory is working on four pillars. Two of them are really important for us today. The Thales Digital Platform, for sure, I will come back in a minute, and the MVP delivery, which are projects which are hosted in the Thales Digital Factory and that are using what we provide to them to create new digital products. Other pillar are startup incubators and digital academy, but I won't go further on those two topics. So the Thales Digital Platform, what it is? We will see this in a minute. And first, I will go in the MVP explanation. So we have a way of working at the Thales Digital Factory. We have project teams, so autonomous project team that have different skills in the team. So UX, DevOps, developers, persons that, designers and so on, which are working in the same squad and have the mission for 3 months to create a new product for the business line of Thales. They have 3 months to bootstrap a new product, to define the technical basis, to initiate the product, to find the customer, and so on and so on, and to prove the value of the project. So we call this kind of project MVPs. And we have several teams working on different MVPs that are submitted and selected among different propositions of Thales business lines. So with this way of working, MVPs team needs to jump into the code really quickly. They do not have 2 months to set up a development platform and a runtime platform. They have to have tools that are able to receive their work really, really quickly. And that's where Thales Digital Platform came into the story. So here we have some example of MVP. So for example, Partage, which is a new services that is available for airline companies to manage their spare parts in a more efficient way thanks to the digital economy. And basically it's a kind of Amazon of spare flying spare parts, for example. We have other MVPs, but I won't go into the detail of such MVPs. The Thales Digital Factory provide a set of services which are dedicated to those MVPs and also to the business line after the incubation in the factory to make this product easier to build, quicker to build, and also more safe and so on. So we have different bricks, and the one that interests us today is the application runtime services. So this application runtime had some requirements. So as I said before, we want to use Agile and DevOps paradigm. So DevOps is not only about tooling, it's about the mindset and the way we use tools, basically. And we wanted a platform to build and run digital product compared to platform to build and a platform to run the project. And also, we wanted to make the iteration on the product increment as easy as possible to deploy. Also, we wanted to be cloud agnostic, yet we choose Azure data centers as a public backend, but we wanted also to be able to deploy it on-premise, and that's why you can imagine we pick Cloud Foundry. So, as I said, we want a really good velocity for the business. We don't want developer talking about creating a VM, patching an OS, all of this kind of task that has no added value and that does not help developers to create an MVP in only 3 months. So increasing developer productivity is really something that is important for us, and that explains the choice of Cloud Foundry. I didn't mention it because that's obvious to me, but Thales, we work in several domains. which are really critical. So it includes aerospace, transportation, aviation, or defense, energy, and security is obviously something that is really important for us because we host critical payload. And what we wanted to achieve with our platform is to have something secured by design, to provide something to the MVPs, which is already prepared to some, which already have some security criteria that are, that is important for our application. And last but not least, we wanted to mutualize the operation of the platform and to have a good ratio between the operators and developer. So that was our requirements. And we pick a technology, Cloud Foundry, and a partner to help us in this journey, Pivotal.
So as was explaining Nicolas, we initially, so we started, Pivotal started to discuss with Tel Digital Factory, and we discovered that our proposal, so the value proposition of Pivotal Cloud Foundry and Cloud Foundry itself, very much the requirements. So it was there is a kind of 1+1 equals 3 that we are going, we will be able to build together. And one of the statements they share at the beginning of the discussion is that there is no managed platform that can achieve the level of security that they want to build. There is no PaaS offering today on the market that they can take as it is and deploy products implemented by the business line. So I think it was one of the things that phrased the level of the goals of this digital platform that really need to raise the bar in terms of security compared to what you have today in the public cloud market. And also because, yes, there needs transparency and control over the infrastructure, even if they are running in the public cloud. So really key things, focus on developer experience, I was saying. So 3 months MVP, you want to very quickly deploy something. You cannot spend time to build infrastructure. You want to achieve velocity through your pipeline very, very quickly. You want scalability. Could be obvious for people that are building cloud native app or using public cloud. But I was explaining, Nicolas, Thales is building system. They deploy complete system on customer premise most of the time, and when you need to scale, it's basically you often need to redesign and redeploy. So it takes a long time, it's years sometimes just to update things. So when you speak and you explain them that they can, through a simple command, can scale and multiply the number of instances and really brings new features in weeks versus years, it's really a key differentiator. Abstraction provided by Bosch for the cloud elasticity, security by design with a 3R approach that most of the enterprises that are adopting Cloud Foundry is using, and the low cost that is brings in terms of operational, at the operational level that is provided by Bosch was really what makes the difference and is really a great fit, I think, at the beginning of the conversation we had 1 year ago with the factory. And at least also what was, I think, very important is that the reference base that has Cloud Foundry. So we had Comcast, for instance, that is running more than 20,000 containers in production. So there is no doubt about the capacity of the solution to scale. And there is also no doubt about the solution to fit with specific industry like defense industry. With example like US Air Force that is doing great things in US with Cloud Foundry.
Okay, so we, in addition of the Cloud Foundry technology, we were expecting a partner to help us in this journey. As I mentioned this morning, the initial step, the setup of the platform, if you are new to the technology, it's quite complex. Also, for the evolution of the mindset of the developers on the proper way to use this tool, we ask Pivotal to help us on this. So we start our journey with a dojo. that accelerate the deployment, the initial deployment of the platform, and we adopt right at the beginning the best practice on the operation of the platform. It helps us also to have this mindset platform as a product, and to how to communicate, to describe the value of our platform, what we can expect from it, when from the perspective of a developer, and it was really helpful to in our discussion with our users. And for the daily support, when we have some bugs, and we are a small team in the operation team, so when there is some bug, dig somewhere into the multiple modules and layers of Cloud Foundry, we can count on Pivotal to help us and to be able to respond more quickly. And all the enablement of developers using the different frameworks. Spring is one important framework for the community, and Pivotal has a pretty good knowledge on it. So it helps us a lot.
So we are very close to the chance we have with Digital Factory. It's a new entity, so we can start from scratch. Over the time, we will need to integrate more and more with some constraint coming from the Thales group itself. But basically, we can start from a clean page, and so we have the chance to build something very close to what we envision for this kind of platform. So we have developer MVP, MVP that will be handover to the business line later, and they are completely building and running the platform. They can pick the languages they want. And if, I think at some point there is some strategy regarding framework that that the factory will propose to their developer. They are starting to adopt microservices in some way, so adopting Spring Cloud. But it also comes with some challenges. They are building application very quickly during 3 months, so you don't want to end up with a monster design phases or monster microservices architecture after 3 months if you don't have delivered anything to the business. It doesn't make sense. So there is always trade-off to find in terms of innovation, and always stay focused on the business value. So we have more or less 50 developers that are using the platform. The MVP come and leave the factory, so there is much more developers that have been onboarded to the platform for a small team of 3 operators, plus a product owner that drives the roadmap. And in the same way, the platform team is running and building the platform with lots of tooling that are provided by Pivotal Cloud Foundry, like Elsewhere, and also they provide PCF metrics for monitoring and alerting at the application level for the MVP. So all this tooling are very close to, I think, what we propose as the best reference reference architecture for the enterprise using Pivotal Cloud Foundry. But something makes the platform a bit different from what you are used to see. It's the Vormetric integration. So when we decided to work with, when Thales decided to work with Pivotal 1 year ago, as I was saying, they say, okay, we need to go beyond what you are used to do in terms of security, and we have products because we are not only building system, we are also building software. And so they say, do you integrate with Vormetric? So Vormetric is a solution that enable encryption, transparent encryption. So it means it's done at the file system level, so it's completely transparent for the user, for the developer. And so we say yes, no, we do not integrate yet, but technically. Because we are using open source standard through open service broker and Bosch layer like Bosch add-on, everything is possible. So they were convinced by the value proposition of Bosch, and the ecosystem team of Pivotal has worked with the engineering team of Thales Vormetric to build the product, which is a VT, so Vormetric Transparent Encryption for PCF, that is now available on the Pivotal Network website, but in a beta program, so it's only for early adopter user. We can speak about it later if you want. But what does it mean exactly for the developer? So for the developer, it means that if they pick MySQL, for instance, in the data in the marketplace, they spin up the database, but behind the scene, the MySQL will be transparently encrypted. What does it mean? It means that if I am a Bosch operator and I SSH into the VM where my MySQL is running and I look at the file of my MySQL, I cannot read anything. Everything is encrypted, and the only team that can read the data is the owner of the key, which is the MVP. So there is a mechanism of agent base. So the Bosch add-on deploy an agent in each MySQL VM that registers to a central DSM, which is managing the security and the key. So everything is done smoothly, transparently for the developer. And at the end, you end up with something very secure, where even Azure or Microsoft, if they get into the VM, they cannot read the data. So it means that you can have public, you can have secure data even if you are running in the public cloud.
Okay, so this is a kind of summary of our journey. So Digital Factory was born in at the end of in Q3 2017. And at that time, we decided to go on Cloud Foundry with Pivotal. So it was a setup of a brand new company. So technical work starts with the availability of an alpha platform, which was really a test platform provided by Pivotal. And so that developer ops team can start operating, testing the platform, and it was really at an early phase. Things, the platform that is running now was the exact date of born is at the beginning of the year of this year. So in January, we had a dojo with Pivotal. So three guys from three person from Pivotal joined our team, and we peer with a PO, so we were a pair of PO and two pairs of architects. And during this month, we set up all the initial steps of the platform. We create all the DevOps code to provision the underlying infrastructure on Azure, and also all the and we deploy the different foundation. Okay, and we also deploy the automated operational process, so the backup, the monitoring. So at the end of the month, we had an MVP platform with most important features covered, yes, for only a V1, but still a platform which was running and that we can used to onboard a first beta MVP so that he can test the platform while we were improving, for example, the security, improving the way we automate some different operational tasks. So it was in the dojo, and we had our first digital product in production after 3 months this year. So it was production with a limited number of users, but still we have all the process to put an application dev, QA, then prod with security testing and so on. And we have our first MVP that was transferred to the business line and operated by the business line, operated and enhanced because it's build and run. It's not just we deliver a product and then it's done. It's a running product which is continuously improved by a squad in the business line, and the first handover was done at the beginning of the summer. Now we are here, we are getting more and more MVPs and users on the platform. We are continuing to automate process. We are working on day two operation to make sure our platform will be safe in the future. And we are also, I will talk later on the roadmap. But what we can say in terms of metrics, we have 15 digital products that are in progress on our platform with a lot of deployment, which is a good for our objectives. What we see is that we reduce the number of ops per application when we use the Cloud Foundry platform, the Pivotal Cloud Foundry platform. We have 50 developers that spend most of their time to code, which is good, not doing infrastructure. Maybe the 20% of rest is taking coffee, which is good also. And we can fix really quickly and efficiently problems that we may have in production. And one important metric is the time between an idea and something in production. So this value is coming from the MVP team. When they try to implement something and they put it in prod, they are able to do it in 2 days now. And before in Thales, it was maybe months. So we can see this is really important. We have a good availability so far, so let's cross the finger and keep it like this. And as I said this morning, we are able to deliver, to onboard a new project really quickly and to make them ready to work, to code, and to push their apps really, really quickly.
So one of the things that is critical is that so the business line is the starting, the beginning of the journey. So the digital factory is the beginning of the journey. So 3 months implementation, but then it goes to the business line. So and what we discover is that once the project come back to the business line, the fact that we are based on a very simple API, and so the usability of the platform is very high and very easy for the developer. It really facilitates the adoption, so you don't end up with a monster architecture with a bunch of scripts that you have to maintain. So it really limits the technical depth for the business line. They just get the source code of the application, that is the business value, but they do not have infrastructure code to maintain. So it really makes successful. So not only the platform doesn't make only successful the implementation of the product inside the digital factory, but how then it's handover to the business line. And I think it will be a key criteria in the future, because the more we will get feedback about this success from the business line, more it will make the digital factory comfortable with the value proposition of the platform.
Okay, so quickly, because I think we are running out of time, so more and more digital product. We shorten the path to production for new products, and the onboarding is quick. We provide a secure access pass, so when we push the first time an application on our platform, we check a set of security stuff that are required and that's built in with the platform, so developers do not have to spend time on it. We still have some work, fortunately. We want to extend the marketplace. We heard a lot about the service broker, so I'm sure we will progress on this in the coming months. We are hiring, as we said this morning also. See, you want to work as an ops or as a dev, come. We have a lot of challenges in Paris, so and you will be really welcome. And yes, we are the platform team is still is not we are not Jedi right now. We are still learning new stuff. We are still improving the platform, so we will continue to learn this, and we need to explore the hybrid configuration. So this is what is our next steps. So we want to refine how we do the billing with our platform for the different entities. We want to be able to define the SLA. So we are learning how the platform works and what we can promise to our customer, and continue to have support and so on. And we want to continue to have a dev team environment and so on. And we had a lot of discussion on Kubernetes. We wanted maybe to complement our offer with Kubernetes for some payloads that does not fit yet with Cloud Foundry, and we are willing to understand how the community will tackle these challenges. It is time for question. A little sprint for the end. So,
what do you use for monitoring?
We have two different monitorings. So the question is, what do we use for monitoring? And in fact, we have two different monitoring. We have a Prometheus. We use Prometheus for with a lot of different metrics, a lot of dashboards, and for let's say a summary of all the most important KPI. We have Healthwatch, which is a product of Pivotal, and which has the advantages of regroup the most important stuff in one dashboard.
Coming also from Thales, I can speak for the business lines here. I'm from the transport systems division, so we're working together with these people from Digital Factory and with the community in order to bring this technology to our customers. So we are actually going to the customers and working with them. And with respect to that question here, we have, of course, asset management systems around, legacy, and we're going for new ones. And we integrate Prometheus and the things into that systems because this is a broader range of integrating not only the digital world but also the analog world out there, the things which are actually near the tracks, near the in the trains and so forth. So it's a bigger picture where we integrate this stuff at the moment, and we are happy to do the journey here with together with the Digital Factory.
Any other question? What is the lunch, maybe, is the question?
Let's find out. Thank you.
OK, so thank you.